Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week comes from Betty and David, who sent us this beautiful photo of a field of Indian paintbrush on their property. And they'd like to know why these normally red flowers occasionally show up in different colors. Well, with all the recent flap over maroon blue bonnets showing up on the University of Texas campus here in Austin, you might already know the answer. Like all living organisms that reproduce sexually, wildflowers have genes from two different parents, each with their own unique characteristics. And some of those characteristics are dominant, while others are recessive. If the recessive trait gets passed on to the offspring from both parents, that trait will be visible. But usually, the dominant trait gets passed on from at least one parent, so the recessive trait doesn't get expressed. And in Castileja, or Indian paintbrush, red is the dominant floral color. But we asked Damon Waite at the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center about this, and he told us that there are also light yellow and even white flowering variants of this plant in nature. Perhaps if there were a maroon flowering variant, one of my Aggie horticulture colleagues would have collected and propagated it by now, like we did with the maroon bluebonnet. Or perhaps if there were a deep burnt orange variant, an alum from my botanical cohort at UT Austin might have done so as well. But alas, Castileja is not our state flower, and so producing unique cultivars of it, it's not a task that anyone's yet taken on. But if you wanted to, you'd need to scour the fields each year and find any color variants that you were interested in. Then make sure that the flowers were not cross-pollinated by any of the nearby normal red ones, perhaps even encouraging self-pollination. And then return later to collect those seed and steal them away to plant and propagate in a greenhouse where you could be more protective of their promiscuity. There are a few other details about this wildflower that might make you think twice about taking on this task. Not only does it have a hard seed coat, requiring very specific climatic conditions to germinate, it's also a hemiparasite. And that means that Indian paintbrush has to be planted near certain other host species plants or it won't grow. Bluebonnets are just one host species for Castileja, which is why you often see them growing together in wildflower meadows. Some of our native prairie grasses and sedges also serve as host species. So you see, isolating and producing all of the wonderful plants that we have available for our modern gardens is not as easy as it may seem. Our plant this week is fall aster, one of our great Central Texas natives. As its name implies, it flowers in the fall, but spring is the best time to plant. The flowers are a delicate blue-purple with yellow button centers. Bees just love this plant, and it serves as a crucial source of nectar for them in the fall, when very little else may be blooming. Fall aster usually stays less than 2 feet tall and about as wide, growing into a small mound. It looks great planted in the foreground and along the edges of planting beds. Fall aster is a hardy perennial and has no trouble at all with our winters here in Central Texas. Giving them a good shearing in the spring reinvigorates growth and makes the plants bushier and healthier. It also encourages more flowers. The aromatic leaves of fall aster are a little pungent, and although nothing is deer-proof, their scent makes this plant deer-resistant. Fall asters prefer well-drained soil and need very little water once established. To do in your garden this week, consider planting some heat-loving annuals like marigold or zinnia into containers or in any bare spots in your garden. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit us at klru.org/ctg to send us your pictures and questions.